Good morning and good afternoon to everyone, and welcome to this webinar about the robotic total station. Okay, so let's start with this webinar. So this webinar is about the robotic total station. What we will see in this webinar is okay, a quick introduction. So what is the robotic total station for who of you don't know? Then we will see the different application that we can approach using a robotic total station, and then we will go more in detail. In particular, we will discuss about the technology, so the internal technology of a robotic total station. So we see what we call the Scout, the AIM, and the Truck. What are these technology that we use to find, follow, and measure precisely the center of the prism. Then we will discuss about the accuracy. This is an interesting topic because so we all know that we always speak about 1 second, 2 second, 5 second total station, but at the end, what is the real accuracy in millimeter? Because at the end, when we want a result, we evaluate the accuracy of a result in millimeters, not in seconds. So what is at the end the accuracy to locate a prism in millimeters using a robotic total station? Because at the end, it's not only the 1 second, 2 second, but there are more factors, also some more than what we have to consider if we use a manual total station. And then to conclude, we will see how to work with the field software. So we will see the technology, all what is behind a measure, and then we will see how to do a measure with the field software. That at the end we will see that is for sure the most easy part of all the topics that we will discuss. If you have any question, you can directly write the question in the panel that you have here in the GoToWebinar panel. You have a space to write your questions, and then I will reply your question at the end of the webinar. Okay, so let's start. Robotic total station, this is probably already all of you know, is the evolution of the classic manual total station. So with the robotic total station, in general, we can do all the operation that we do with a manual total station, but with a single operator working from the pole side, because the robotic total station has some technology that we can use, like the automatic prism search, the tracking, so all the function that we can trigger from the pole. So we don't need to have one operator on the pole, one operator on the total station, but one operator from the pole is able to do everything. Measure, drawing, everything directly from the pole. But not only, because the robotic total station also allow to approach different applications that normally we cannot do with a manual total station. So we have not to consider the robotic total station just as an evolution. Also, what I said of a manual total station in the meaning that we can work from a single operator. But the robotic total station is really an instrument that allow also to approach different tasks that normally we cannot do with a manual total station. So also on a job point of view, robotic total station really provide much, much more benefit than only working with one operator instead of two. And then we will see what are these applications that we can do with the robotic total station. If we talk about the standard configuration, if we work with a robotic total station, in general, we have, okay, the total station. This is our model, the Zoom 90. As you can see, here we have this antenna over the robotic total station that is used for the communication. We will see later in the presentation that we will talk about active and passive prism, the different communication that we have from total station to the pole. In GeoMax, we use the passive prism, so the communication that we use is the long-range Bluetooth, but we only use it to communicate to the controller, to the field controller, not to communicate with the prism. So we have this long-range Bluetooth. In general, with standard controller, standard devices, the range is about 250 meter, 300 meter, but in some case with a special controller is also possible to reach 700-800 meters. Then, as we said, we use a prism. So in GeoMax we use a passive prism, so any prism can be used for this task. In general, if we work with one operator, we want to use a 360 prism, but we can also use a standard circular prism. And then a remote controller. As we said, for the communication between the robotic total station and the controller, we use the long-range Bluetooth. It is a very stable communication, not very power-consuming. Don't have problem with regulation with radios, because normally with the radios is much more complicated, because in some country you cannot use some frequency. So long range Bluetooth is the perfect technology for the communication. As we said, in general, for example, if we use a standard Android controller, we can say that the range is about 250 and 300 meters, so normally more than enough for standard jobs. Application. So, for sure, robotic total station can be used for the standard surveying and stakeout application in one-man configuration. But not only, because, for example, we can use robotic total station also for continuous monitoring. Not all, also single and continuous monitoring, because so we have the motors inside the robotic total station that allow to automatically measure the prism over the time. And is not another type of robotic total station. So the same total station, then one day I use for stakeout, for construction stakeout, the next day, because, for example, I have a job that require to make a monitoring, I can use the same robotic total station, the same software, the same configuration to make a continuous monitoring. So as you can imagine, this is a big plus of robotic total station. This is not something that with a manual total station I can do. But also I can use it for what we can call maybe special application. So for example, as you can see from this picture, we can use the robotic total station together with a georadar. In this case, the georadar automatically, sorry, the robotic total station automatically measured the prism over the GPR, over the georadar, and provide the position to the georadar software on the notebook. Also, in this case, it's not something I can do with a manual total station. And in the same, at the end, is similar, we can also do with machine control. Or we can also use the robotic total station for high accurate surveying, because we will discuss later with motorized total station, we have also the auto-targeting of the prism. So a robotic total station will be, in general, always, we will have a better accuracy than a manual total station, because we are sure that we measure the center of the prism. So just in general, what are the benefits of a robotic total station? So accurate measurements, we will see later, then with a robotic total station with the IM technology, we always measure the center of the prism. And this means that we have a very good accuracy. Greater productivity, because for sure, if we work with, I do the job, I do everything from the pole, so I can use the correct codes. I can do the correct drawing. I know what I am measuring. So in the normal setup with a manual total station, when we have two operators, one from the total station, one from the pole, so as you can imagine, if I work from the pole, I know maybe the correct code, because I see what I am measuring, if it is a rod, if it is a sidewalk. If I measure from the total station, then I have to enter the code, but so I always need to communicate. So for sure, with a robotic total station, I really increase the productivity. Also, especially for the stakeout, because to stake out a point with a robotic total station is similar to a GPS. I have not to say, okay, 50 centimeters to the right, 10 centimeters in my direction. So with robotic total station, I have a real-time stakeout, similar to the GPS. I reduce the number of mistakes, first of all, because one operator is less difficult to make gross error. But also, using the IAM technology, I am always sure that I am measuring the prism. So the angle is very accurate. Better quality for the same reason. And as we said in the previous slide, we have also the flexibility to approach different job tasks. And this is, I think, is one of the greatest points for today's customer, because normally we are surveying, maybe today is doing a stakeout job, but maybe next week there is a job to do a monitoring. Then maybe they have a different type of job. So robotic total station allows this flexibility. So with a single instrument, I can really approach different applications. Okay, now let's start to talk a bit more in detail about the technology inside a robotic total station. So let's go a bit more in detail. Normally, a robotic total station can do three main functions that are the 360 prism search. So the robotic total station scan the job site to find the prism, because imagine that I am working from the pole side. Second, after the prism is found, the total station lock the prism. Lock the prism is what we mean, okay, the total station know where is the prism and is able to follow the prism. And is what we call tracking. So first of all, a 360 prism search, then the prism is locked and tracked. And then the total station, when I press measure on the software, the total station automatically measures the center of the prism. So we have an initial search. Then the total station lock the prism. I measure the distance, so I store or I stake out the point. Then in case the prism is lost, I search again the prism, because for example, I move between a wall. So for sure, if there is not the intervisibility, the total station lose the prism, I need to search again the prism. So this is the standard workflow of all robotic total station in the market. Now just let's see a video to explain better this solution. Is what in Geomax we call Stream, because this technology in Geomax are the Scout, the Track, and the IAM. So the Scout is the 360 search, Track is the prism tracking, and the IAM is the auto target, so the automatic measure of the center of the prism. So you see, first of all, we start with the Scout. So the Scout makes a very fast 360 search, then lock the prism, and we'll start with the tracking. So now the prism is locked, so it's automatically tracked, and when I measure a point, it will use the IAM technology to measure exactly the center of the prism. Then when I move again, track and IAM. So this is the workflow of a robotic total station. So the three main technology are the Scout, so fast rotation when the laser search the prism in the entire job area, the Track, so once the prism is found, the total station continuously follow the prism, and the IAM 360, so the telescope measure automatically the center of the prism for a very, very accurate measurement. Now let's talk about these three technologies more in detail. First of all, the Scout 360. So the Scout 360 uses an invisible laser to scan the job area to locate for the prism. It, as we also said in the beginning, but we will also discuss more in the next part, it is a passive system, where the laser beam scan the area while instrument rotate horizontally. Sorry. So if in the passive prism, the prism don't emit any signal to the total station. So in a passive system, it is it only using the laser fan in the total station to find where is the prism. Then when the prism is found, the rotation stop and the prism is locked. What is the range? The range is 300 meters. Scan time for a full rotation is around 5-10 seconds, and it uses a laser technology. So let's show this video. I would like also to thank one of our dealers that I copied part of this video because it's really well done. So as you see, when we click on search, the total station make a very fast 360 rotation and lock the prism. This is what we call Scout 360 and work more or less in a 300 meters range. Track 360. So when the prism is locked, so after the 360 search, the robotic total station follows the prism. In this case, it uses again a laser beam to follow the prism during the movement and also uses some software function to avoid to lose the prism if there is an obstacle. This is called path prediction. In general, so if we move behind a tree, behind a pillar, the prism is not lost. So I don't have every time to make a search again. The prism is only lost if I am hidden by an obstacle for several seconds, in general 5 seconds. The track, so after the prism is locked, the total station is able to follow the prism up to 800 meters far away from the total station. And this is the speed. So at 100 meters, it is 90 kilometers per hour. So for sure, much more than what is really needed. Let's show also again a video about the tracking. So this is what is the tracking. So you see, after the prism is locked, here you see that is the camera is inside the telescope. So we are able to show very well. You see the prism move behind some obstacle, but the prism is not unlocked. Oh, sorry, it stopped. Okay, you see you move behind the trees with the prism, but the tracking is not lost. You see? Absolutely is not lost. So if the prism is hidden only for a few seconds after an obstacle, the prism is not lost. Then if you are hidden for more time, you see the prism can be lost, but at the end is enough to click very quickly on search and the prism is locked again. Very simple, okay? So you see on the field side, it's very easy to operate with a robotic total station. Also because now the technology is already the state of art of the technology. So robotic total station are several years in the market. So they are very, very stable. So the risk to have what is called false locks is very, very much reduced. Okay, so this is what we call a track. Last technology is what we call AIM. So AIM is the technology for the prism recognition when we measure the prism. In general, this is used. So when we press measure the prism, the total station emits this an infrared laser and the signal is reflected by the prism. So this image is what the total station receives, okay? This white part is the prism, the image of the prism, because this infrared laser is processed by this CMOS sensor, that is at the end like an imaging sensor, analyze this image and calculate exactly where is the center of the prism. I receive as a support several times the question, I pressed measure, but when I look inside the telescope, the prism is not exactly at the center. Is not exactly on the center of the reticle of the telescope. This is normal because the software automatically compensates the offset. This is done also to save the total station micro movement. So even if you look inside the prism and the prism is not exactly centered, is absolutely normal, but since the total station received the image, also calculated a different offset. So this is absolutely normal. Exactly, so the software calculates the center of the prism thanks to this image. So I calculate the deviation of the center of the telescope, combine these calculated value, the instrument calculate at the end the horizontal vertical angle, and as consequence calculate the final coordinate. Here the range is even bigger, is 1 kilometer. So the IM work with 1 second accuracy, so it's very, very accurate, with maximum 1,000 meter. Why we have this different range? So you see, with IM we have 1,000 meter of distance. With the Scout we have only we have 300 meters. Why there is this difference? Because we can use the IM, for example, for monitoring application. So for monitoring application, maybe we measure some prism at 800 meters far away, but we don't need the Scout, because in a monitor application, we know where is the prism, more or less. It's moving a few centimeters, okay? But we know the area where the prism is located, because the IM is able to find the prism in a 3 second, more or less, 3 second area. So it's able to make a little search, okay? These are the three technologies: Scout, Track, and IM. Active of passive prism. So this is an interesting argument, because you can see in the market that there are different brands doing robotic total station. And in general, we can divide the technology in two parts. So the technology that use the active prism and the technology using passive prism. Geomax, but also as other hexagon company, like a Geosystem, we use the passive prism. What is meaning of passive prism or active prism? So passive prism are in general prism that just use the prism reflector, reflection, sorry, to identify the prism. Active prism, instead, there is a radio inside the prism that emits a unique code to the total station to identify that is the correct prism and where is precisely the prism. In general, but this is so both the system, they have benefits for sure, because with passive prism we have this benefit: we have no electronic components inside the prism, so for sure it's more robust and durable, less expensive, because we have only a prism, we have not a battery, we have not electronic components. We can use Geomax prism, for example, but we can use prism for other from other brands, any prism. So there are different benefits. On the other side, active prism, they have the benefit that we eliminate the false prism. But in general, what I would like to say is that now the technology is really the state of art technology. Now is really the risk to have false peaks also in passive prism is very, very reduced. Also in XPAD, in our field software, we have some function. We will talk in the next webinars called GeoTrail, Fixed Target Scan, that allow to only be able to lock my prism. So we will see that. So in our opinion, the passive prism in this moment probably is the best system to choose for different reasons, because it's more robust, less expensive. And on the other side, the risk to have false locks is very, very low at the end. Another question, robotic observer. So now we talked about Scout, Track and IM, but as you see also, different brands provide in general two different type of robotic total station. Now, in general, we call all total station, we call robotic, but to be correct, there are two different types: what is called fully robotic and what is called servo. What is the difference? Robotic total station is what we have seen, so allowed 360 prism search. They are indicated in general for all application, in particular for one man. And then we have other total station that are called servo. Servo are also motorized total station, but they don't have the 360 prism scan. So what is the difference? In this case, the prism can be tracked and locked, but not searched 360 degree in the job site, because they have not the Scout, they have less hardware inside. So in general, they are also less expensive. because there is less hardware. So the part of the laser fan to find with the scout the prism is missing in a servo total station. In general, servo total station are used for monitoring jobs, high accuracy job when I work from the total station, but can also be used for one-man operation using some software solution. For example, we will see in the next webinar, XPOL, GeoTrail, the joystick, and we can use a servo total station as a fully robotic. Just to show what we have in the GeoMax portfolio, in GeoMax portfolio we have two robotic total stations that are the Zoom 70 and the Zoom 90. The Zoom 70 is the servo, the Zoom 90 is the fully robotic. And as you see, everything is the same, just the Scout, so the 360 Prism Search, is missing. Okay, next part. Now let's go in detail with a very interesting topic that I'm sure not everyone is so aware how to calculate the real accuracy of a total station. This we will talk about the accuracy of our total station, but this in general is valid for all total station in the market. When we talk about the accuracy at the end, so what is the accuracy? What is the estimation on what will be the accuracy in locating the position of a prism? Okay, so when we see a total station in general, okay, it is a 1 second total station, 2 second total station, but in reality, what is in millimeter the error to measure a prism with a robotic total station? We have different factors that influence the accuracy. First of all, the angular accuracy of the instrument. If I have a 1 second total station, I will have a different accuracy than using a 5 second. But also the type of the prism that I am using. In particular, with the robotic, this is very, very important, the type and the centering accuracy of the prism. The EDM accuracy, so the accuracy for the distance, because a coordinate is calculated by horizontal angle, vertical angle, but also by slope distance. So the accuracy of the EDM of the slope distance. And then we have external conditions. So if I am under the rain, sunlight condition, so also the much very, very important is the accessories that I am using. So if I am using a not very robust tri-brack, I will have more error, in particular using a robotic total station, than standard tri-brack. In fact, in GeoMax, if you buy a 1 second total station, you will have a much more robust and performing tri-brack than if you buy a 5 second total station. But the same also for the pole that you are using. So there are a lot of, also the accessory are very important. Angular accuracy. So you see, normally total station today, they are in a range between 1 second and 5 seconds. But what is the real in millimeter, the accuracy, the theoretic accuracy? So considering a prism at 100 meter, okay? So with a 1 second total station, you see we are half of a millimeter. If we are using a 2 second, we are 1 millimeter. If we are using a 5 second, we are 2 millimeter. 500 meter, for example, if we use a 1 second total station, the error is 2 millimeter. 2 second, 5 millimeter, and 5 second, 1 centimeter. So you see, this is only the error coming from the angular accuracy. So when you buy a total station, you should also consider what is your error that you need. So if you need to do a very, very precise stakeout, in general, in construction, you work with the centimeter in general. So maybe you should choose, for example, a 2-3 second. So that is very, but if you, for example, you are doing a monitoring, okay, maybe with a monitoring is better a 1 second, because then maybe even the 5 centimeter is very important. Second error, and this is very specific for robotic total station, is the centering error. So when we measure with the IM, as you remember from previous slide, you measure the center of the prism. And with IM also you have an error. And depends on the prism. Is the accuracy to be able from the imaging software to measure exactly the center of the prism. And this is the error that you have. So if you use a circular prism, you have 1 millimeter. If you use the standard 360 prism, so you see in GeoMax also we have two different 360 prism, one high accurate, one with the standard accuracy, you have 5 millimeter. So this is also an error that you have to consider. Anyway, believe me, this error will be always better than manually aiming a prism. Because if you use a manual total station and you manually aim, you never will be with this accuracy, for sure. But you have to consider EDM accuracy is the distance accuracy. So in general, with our robotic total station, but more or less all total station, most of total station robotic have this accuracy. In general, you have 1 millimeter plus one part that is the distance depending. So to summarize, what is the accuracy? So we have this graphic. This is valid, as I said, for all robotic total station. Let me try to explain you. You see that, so in the x-axis, you have the distance. Y-axis, you have the error in millimeter. Then you have two lines. The horizontal lines is depending on the prism, and the sloped line is depending on the angular accuracy. So for example, let's take a 2 second total station. So I think that you see my mouse. We are here with this inclined line, okay? And then we have also to see what is the prism that I am using. So for example, I have a 2 second total station with a circular prism. So you see that with a circular prism, that is the ZPR100, we are never better than 1 millimeter because 1 millimeter is the center accuracy. So below around 80 meters, we are always minimum 1 millimeter wrong. Then depending on the distance, the accuracy increase. So for example, at, I don't know, 500 meter, we are around 6 millimeters, because then we have the EDM error, we have the angular error, and so on. If we have, for example, again, a 2 second total station, but a standard 360 prism, so the ZPR1, you see, my accuracy will never be better than 5 millimeter. Then after 500 meters, so if the distance range increase from 500 meter to, for example, 800 meter, you see, at 800 meter, my accuracy is 8 millimeter. So with a 360 prism and a 2 second station, we can say that the accuracy will be never better than 5 millimeter and will increase after 500 meter, will increase up to 8 millimeter at 800 meter. So this is a very interesting accuracy that show how the accuracy is calculated from angular accuracy, prism type, and distance. Okay, let's last part of our webinar, how to operate with the field software. So now we have seen the technology. Honestly, everything what is in behind looks complicated, but when we operate from the field, it's very simple. What is more complicated is, okay, to understand the technology, but this is done automatically by the total station, and understand the accuracy, because at the end we are technician. So it's very important from us to understand clearly how the accuracy is calculated, because it's not true that I need the 0.5 second. Okay, maybe, but depends on the job that we are doing. So we need, first of all, to be able to calculate the correct accuracy, to understand what is the accuracy that we will provide in a job, but also we have to check what is the accuracy that is required for a job. Because if we are doing a construction, normally in the construction will be never better requested an accuracy better than 1 centimeter. So we have to consider all these kind of different scenarios. So let's talk about the field software. In the field software, in general, we have three steps, what we talked before. So the scout, the track, and the IM. In the software, everything is done automatically. We have some dedicated windows to make the search, but I want to show you directly how the software work in the, sorry, how the, this function work in our software. So this is the main interface of our tablet. Okay, this is a Samsung tablet because we provide Xpad, that our field software is compatible with all Android devices. So in this case, it's with a Samsung, but we have also some GeoMax Android controller. We can press the search function. The Prism will search 360 degree for the Prism, the Scout, and then it will lock the Prism. The status on the field software will change from unlocked to locked, and then we can start to measure. So you see the status changed to locked. We can also use the function search left and search right. This is the same. So if we just press search, it will be in the default direction. But if we want to make it simple, we have also some function to search left, search right, or we can also indicate the search window. Because, for example, I only work in a short area, you know, sorry, in a small area that maybe my construction site, my road site. So I can limit also the search, and then you see the total session will follow the Prism. So this is the tracking. So you see I move with the Prism, the total station directly follow the Prism. Automatically, and then I can do all the field operation, measures, takeout, everything, and the total station continuously follow the Prism. At the end, as you see, we talked much more in this webinar about the technology, the accuracy, because so my goal was to do a webinar more to give you more technical information, interesting information. Just for the software, my goal was just to show how it is easy at the end operate with the field software, because what the technology, the accuracy, the IM, Scout, everything is done in background by the Total Station. In the field software, what we have to do is just to use the correct search function, but then it's very simplified what is the job in the field. Okay, we finished our webinar. I was perfectly on time because I planned around 35-40 minutes for this webinar. We have time for the question. So if you have any question, please write your question in the chat. I see here already a question. I will reply now. I also, in the meantime, I would like to remember you that if you want also to join our webinar here in our events, in our events page, you can already register to the coming webinar, but also you will receive if you are following us also on LinkedIn or on Facebook, you will see the links also for the next webinar. We plan to do one webinar every week until July, and then probably we will continue with this project. Okay, so here a question, if this webinar will be done again. No, this will be done again today, later, but in French language, also to cover our other countries. Anyway, when we will close the webinar, you will receive an email, then by GoToWebinar with the link to download the video. But also, we will upload this video on the GeoMax YouTube channel. So in case also you want to see later the webinar, it will be uploaded, but you can just find the link in the email. Okay, here there is the question is about the TriBrack, to explain again, because before I mentioned it quickly, the TriBrack that we have in GeoMax for robotic total station. So the TriBrack is very important for a robotic total station, because in particular, when the total station rotate for the Scout, for the different motorized movement, it provide a big big force on the TriBrack. So if the TriBrack is not very, very rigid, there will be very small distortion on the tribrach. And probably if you are working a short range, you will not see. But if you measure like 500 meters, for example, even a small error in the tribrach will be maybe 1 centimeter error at 500 meters, considering the angle. So in Geomax, if you are using zoom 90 1 second, because at the end there are very small errors, so you only appreciate if you have a 1 second total station, we will normally in the package we provide a tribrach with a better quality than the 2 second and 5 second. It's a specific tribrach with a tested very high rigidity of the accessory. This is also why not only Geomax, also like other brands, recommends in general to use their own accessory, because sometimes if you use you have a 1 second total station, but then you use a poor quality tribrach, a poor quality prism, then is absolutely not necessary to have a 1 second total station if maybe your error will come from the accessory you are using. Here is immediately another question related to this topic. Sorry, let me start again. Okay, let me go back to this page. So honestly, I don't have other information about using not Geomax prism. What is the accuracy? In general, I would say that with a Geomax prism, the accuracy circular prism is 1 millimeter. I would say that in general, with circular prism, maybe also using other brands, is not a big difference. Much important probably is using the 360 prism, because to build a 360 prism is much more delicate. So probably there will be much more important. But anyway, the accuracy that we provide is for our prism that are all tested. For a prism of other brands, is much more difficult, honestly, to estimate what is the accuracy. Okay, for sure, I was expecting this question. So what is the price? What is the price of a robotic total station? So here, it's not that the price is hidden, absolutely not. It's just that in Geomax, we don't sell directly. We have a dealer network. So if you want to have information about the products, the price, everything, you can directly go in our website. Here we have the find the distributor with all the country where we are available, and then with email and everything. So you can feel free to send an email to our dealer network and they will provide you everything, price, discount, product, packages, everything. So just feel free to contact them for everything. You can find directly in our website. Okay. So I hope that you really enjoyed this webinar. And in this case, I hope to see you also again the next week, where we will have a webinar. In this case, we will talk about the GPS technology. So we will talk about the new constellation, Beidou, Galileo, the new frequency, L2, L5, and what benefit this new frequency provides for us in the field. So I hope to see you all again the next week. And thank you again for everyone. For any question, maybe you will have problem to find the video. I don't know, any question also for your wish. I would like a webinar talking about, laser rotator. Just write us an email and we will try to help you. Okay, thank you again and have a nice day.